Katie Dickey suffers from spinal muscular atrophy, but that doesn't keep her from competing in wheelchair soccer or working on a college degree. And it didn't keep her from coming to rural Uganda. Katie traveled to Africa with a small group of interns organized by the Johnny and Friends Ministry.
When the children see me in a wheelchair, see me, even though we look different, we have the same way to get around. And I truly believe that God has opened so many doors for me to connect with these children on a heart level.
The team connected with more than 100 children at a special needs school in Uganda's capital, Kampala. They encouraged teachers and worked with children in the classroom. The volunteers came to realize that these kids are the fortunate ones, as students told them of other children living in far more difficult situations.
And they talked about the children with disabilities in the villages that are sometimes locked away or killed for their disability, and they realized how blessed they are and what an impact God has had in their lives.
As the interns ventured out to rural areas, they met Francis Munyiga, whose family was killed by rebels. Francis lives alone in a dark hut and repairs shoes to support himself.
It was really heartbreaking hearing his story and hearing all the things he's been through, losing his family and the isolation of disability and not having anyone to really support him or love him.
The interns gave Francis a battery-powered lantern to light up his home. They also connected him with a church that cares for disabled people.
And being in a church where he was welcomed and people, I mean, they welcomed him in and celebrated him. I think that was just life-changing for him to see God's people loving on him.
Many Ugandans with disabilities have been told they are worthless, a shame, and a burden to their families. But the visiting team brought a different message, that every person has value. They prayed for them and loved them. They also shared practical caregiving tips with family members. Back at the school, the volunteers spent time one-on-one with students and taught them Bible stories and songs.
The children here are just like the children back home. They just want to be loved and just to spend time together. There was one little boy who I got to talk with, and he was telling me about how his parents just left him on the side of the road. And he asked me if I could look for his parents when I went back home to America. And I told him that my parents did the same thing and I didn't know my parents. And it was okay because me and two of the other friends that were with us, that we loved him and that Jesus loved him and that everything was going to be okay.
Johnny and Friends hope that taking interns overseas will motivate and equip them for missions and for advocacy for people with disabilities around the world.
They always say that, you know, we want God to break our heart for what breaks his, and that's what's happening up here in northern Uganda. And I see these families and these parents, grandparents, that have taken, they've not taken the easy way out. They have decided that their child means something to them. Their child with a disability has value in their eyes and in God's eyes.
Heather Sells, CBN News.